The Murlocks out in Bluegill Marsh are a very... Okay, well, Murlocks are super requested to do on this series. I mean, every other video I get somebody asking to kill Murlocks. And I'll be honest with you guys, I've tried the Murlocks out in Westfall many, many times, but the reality is the respawn on the netters is just absolutely disgusting. It would literally take me over a week to make the 500 kill videos on the netters. So I thought, what would be the next best thing? And, well, I came to the conclusion that these Murlocks out in Bluegill Marsh are probably the second most known Murlocks in, like, the entire game, other than the ones in Elwynn. But the ones in Elwynn barely drop any greens. So at least off these guys, if we're lucky, we'll see some blues, maybe a Shadow Gem, maybe a Moss Agate. I personally have gotten a blue off these guys on my hardcore character who passed away. I'm still raw. I don't like to talk about it because I'm still sad. But my hardcore paladin who passed away a couple weeks ago got a blue off these guys, the Guardian Blade. So I don't know. I'm excited. I think we can get at least a blue. So without further ado, let's clear up our bags a little bit. So without further ado, let's go ahead and reset our kill tracker here and get started with 500 of the Murlocks out here in Wetlands. Let's go. All right, so cool thing about this farm is I guess I'm going to get to rock the pirate hat and the chromatic sword, no problem. And we're also going to be getting clams from these dudes. I know we get clams. So we are going to have a little clam opening, I guess. Probably will be the least hype clam opening you'll ever see on this channel. But it's cool to open clams. But I'm not going to lie, it's kind of crazy. We've done over 80 of these videos and we haven't done Murlocks yet, right? I mean, I'm using Demoralizing Shout to just AoE pull them, by the way. I'm not actually trying to do damage with it. But I mean, isn't that insane? We made over 80 of these videos, and this is our first time killing Murlocks, one of the staples of World of Warcraft creatures. So I'm happy. It feels good to be out here. Oh, our first green, too. The Jagged Star of Power off rip. They are humanoids, right? So, and a scroll of agility, very cool. You guys know me, I love killing humanoids. High chance for potions and cloth and just generally things that sell pretty well. Wetlands has been treating me well the last few weeks as well. I started another hardcore character, an undead priest, and he actually got the Crimson Whelpling. I walked here on a hardcore character, and he got the Crimson Whelpling on, I believe it was 34 kills, which is absolutely ridiculous. So I have good luck in Wetlands. This is one of my personal favorite areas in the game. I also love the little huts that the Murlocks live in. There's something so cozy about these little huts to me. Looks like something I would build in Minecraft, dude. Just a stupid little hut on the beach. Let's go visit these up the coast, actually. There's like a bunch of these different little huts, and these seem to be like the hubs where there's a lot of spawns. So I'll probably just end up going from, like, hut to hut and AoEing these guys down. I don't imagine this will take too long at all. Although, the last farm I did were the Kodos out in Desolus, and that took a lot longer than I thought. I'm not going to lie. I'm pretty bad at gauging how long farms are going to take. Or should I say, I'm pretty bad at Barak gauging. Okay, I'll stop. Now, these shipwrecks are for a quest. I think there's a debuff that, like, turns you into a pirate or something. From these cursed marines. But we're not going to bother with them today. We're going to let those lobbies take care of their quests. Also, there might be some people questing out here. And if there are, I'll just end up hopping off and playing a little Escape from Tarkov and letting the lobbies quest. Because one thing I really don't like doing is taking lobbies mobs when I'm making these farms. I feel really bad. So, if that does happen, that's cool. We'll just leave the spot to the lobbies. But so far, so good. Oh, we're gonna get a blue today, bro. I can just feel it. I can feel it. I can feel the blue coming in my veins. Whoa, was that? Was that a blue? I called it, man. I literally called it like 2 minutes ago. Oh my god. I love this spot. I'm already... Oh, that's insane. I totally called it. You guys heard me. All right. That was like one of the smoothest 99 kills we've had. Already got a blue. Already got like a full bag. Been less than an hour. I don't have much more good things to say, man. I mean, obviously it's just awesome. Like, the respawns are nice, no competition. They're humanoids, so the loot's a flowing. I already got a blue. I mean, literally just no complaints right now. Everything is groovy, but hopefully we can keep it that way. So let's see. For our 500 kill, let's go ahead and pop Recklessness, pop Death Wish. This poor Murlock gets one tapped to the head. And for our 100th Bluegill Murlock, we get 23 copper and a thick-shelled clam. Dude, we are going to have the saddest clam opening ever at the end of this video. But for now, it's time to chomp through 400 more of these guys. So I will talk to y'all when we are at 499 total kills. Here we go. Channeled my inner Matthew McConaughey there, but we're at 499 total kills, and in total this only took about 2.5 hours. I did have to take a couple breaks in between, some IRL stuff, but that doesn't take away from the fact that this was stupidly chill, and it does feel really good to have Murlocks crossed off the list. And I know exactly who we're gonna kill for our 500th kill. We're gonna go ahead and kill Gobbles here. So I don't have too much to say. I wish these guys dropped, like, crazier loot. You know, we do have a lot of thick-shelled clams. I don't know if I'm going to open these on the video just yet, because they are pretty boring. But either way, let's go ahead and knock out our 500th Murlock kill here. And like I was saying, I'm really happy to have these guys crossed off the list. It would be a shame to end the series someday without, you know, having killed Murlocks. That's like Murlocks and Orcs. I struggle to think of a more iconic enemy in World of Warcraft, right? So we had to do this, and we're done with it. So without further ado, let's go ahead, pop Recklessness, pop Death Wish, and for our 500th Murlock kill, we get 70 copper. All right, guys, so much loot today. I had to make like 4 trips to the mailbox just for all these clams, so it's going to take me a minute to move all the loot, but you guys know the drill. I'll catch y'all in Stormwind. Alright guys, so here we are in Stormwind. I finally got all the clams moved, and I thought I was going to do a clam opening, but yo, these clams suck, guys. They can't even have the golden pearls. So I'm just going to give you guys close-up animals shot with a wide-angled lens while I open all these, and I'll talk to you guys in 1 minute when I'm done.
Animals, close-up with a wide-angle lens.
Alright.
Good.
Wasn't that nice? Okay, so looking at those, 132 clams. We did get all this meat, which is basically worthless, dude. And then 9 pearls in total, 7 of the small lustrous pearls, and 2 of the iridescent pearls. I would have shown you guys all the opening, but there were no chance for gold pearls, so it wasn't that hype. Let me grab all the rest of the loot real quick. Alright guys, that took me so long, I don't even want to get into how long that took me to semi-organize this.
Safe
looking
travels.
At the kills here, we are at 500 total. 192 of the Bluegill Murlocks, 110 of the Bluegill Warriors, 96 of the Puddle Jumpers, 63 of the Muck Dwellers, 22 Foragers, 15 Bluegill Oracles, and then 2 kills on Gobbler. I guess I ended up AoEing him down on the way to 500 as well as for the 500 kills. So, then, looking something? At the loot, dude, alright. You guys gotta forgive me today. I can't really manage it more than this. But I can tell you that we broke our record in terms of trash loot today, for sure. So many vendorables here. Let's just get right into the loot. So, we did get a blue, our Stormbringer belt, super nice there. I'll probably be able to get 20, 30 gold for that bad boy. Very nice to have that. And then as far as greens go, nothing too notable. This axe is actually pretty cool for leveling. And then one white shoulder and then one gray shoulder. I wish I had these on my hardcore paladin before he died, but that's okay. Wait a minute, sorry, 3 shoulders. I didn't see these brocade ones here. So, nice little shoulder farm, honestly. A little bit more than one every 130 kills. So, yeah, pretty cool little shoulder farm, I guess you could call that. But, like I was saying, guys, as soon as this clam starts, it all just turns into vendorables. So, I don't know. Look, I could turn some of these things into, like, Murlock Fin Soup or Westfall Stew. But the reality is, guys, these just aren't going to sell. I'm not going to bullshit you guys and tell you that they are. These Murlock eyes and shiny fish scales and shiny slimy Murlock scales, they're as good as vendorables, so let's go ahead and do that. So those guys, we're low level humanoids and we're sitting at 3 gold, 6 silver. That's not too good, obviously, right? But considering they're low level 20s, that's about what I would expect. But when we vendor all of these grays and vendorables, wait, I want that Seer's Fine Steam. When we vendor all of these vendorables, and there's even more in the bank. Alright, I wish this clam meat was worth something, but I've tried to sell it so many different times throughout this series, and it never sells. But either way, we are looking at 6 gold, 87 silver, so more than double what we originally had. Makes sense, right? Because there were just so many crazy items there, and now all that we have left are the auctionables. Alright, so let's start with the blue today, because I like this blue. It's a good one. 5 strength, 2 stam, mail belt. I'm going 1999. Oh my god, Brock, that's so high. I know, but most warriors leveling now are just alts from mages, so they got plenty of gold, bro. We're gonna throw that up. Scrolls of Strength, none for sale right now. We'll do 49 silver a pop on these guys. Seer's Feinstein, 1 gold, 46. Scrolls of Agility, no auctions found. We'll do 46 gold for those. 2 Iridescent Pearls, 62 silver each. 7 Small Lustrous Pearls, 7 silver each. Let's see, 1 Seer's Mantle. I get 3 gold. Shoulders actually sell very well for low levels. Moss Agate, 1 gold, 88 silver. Another pair of shoulders, 74 silver. Healing Pots are at 52 silver. That's crazy that these Healing Pots are at 50 silver. 2 gold for the massive Battle Axe of Stamina. 40 silver for the Brocade Shoulder Pads. 2 gold for the Cleaver of Power. 2 gold for the Fortified Braces of the Eagle. 1 gold for the Jagged Star of Power. And 1 gold for the Buccaneer's Gloves of Spirit. As well as our last item, the Scroll of Protection at 91 silver. Guys, I enjoyed this farm. I know I shouldn't be saying this as much as I do, but I really enjoyed this obscure little farm. I know the gold wasn't crazy, and I'll be honest, as far as Murlocks go, I do still want to do the Netters in Westfall. If you're looking to kill Murlocks for whatever reason, the netters in Westfall have a chance to drop, it's literally a net that you can just use whenever you want, that nets things. So, I'm going to try to do those in the near future, but I'm also going to try to do other obscure weird farms. So, if you have any idea at all, bro, let me know in the comments. I don't care how crazy or weird or obscure or how long it'll take. Let me know if any interesting farms you want to see in the comments below. But I'm really starting to ramble, guys, as usual. I'll leave my Twitch up on screen now. I'm really trying to grow that bad boy before TBC comes out. So if you got a sec, my link's in the description, and I'd kill for a follow over there. But I think that's it for me, guys. I think that's it for this video. If you have any ideas, let me know in the comments. Other than that, like I said, I'm really happy to have this crossed off the list just because as far as World of Warcraft goes, it's all about the orcs and the Murlocks and maybe a couple dragons sprinkled in there. But to me, that's as World of Warcraft as it gets, so I'm feeling good to have this farm crossed off the list. And real quick,
thank you guys for watching. So I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you all for being here. Good luck on your farms. My name is Barack Cage. Take it easy. Have a good one. Don't forget to check out the Twitch link in the description. And I will see you guys in the next one.